we talked about baggage and how Jesus changes you. And for me personally, this year, it just helped me answer some questions and some doubts that I had. With a thousand tongues to lift one cry, then from north to south and east to west, we'd hear Christ be magnified. Really, like, spoke to me was whenever they said that, like, you have baggage, and, like, I really thought about that, and, like, when I was going through it, I, like, looked back on some stuff, and, like, it kind of, like, looked, and I saw how, like, he had taken baggage off, and how, like, I wasn't sad about or any of that. God spoke to me this week by telling me to read the Bible more and pray more. And I also learned this week that everyone has storms, but if you put your faith and trust in Jesus, you can get through those storms. Before I came to camp, I was very doubtful of my faith. I was questioning if God was real because of so much that's happened in my life and made me think, if God's real, then why would he let this happen? If God was real, why did this happen? But started going to church with Kinsey and going to exchange, and I started questioning my doubt. So I was getting more into things. I started like getting curious about God. I started kind of getting interested in it, but not fully getting drawn in. And then I came to church camp, and the first day, I mean, I felt like he was speaking to me whenever he was preaching, but I wasn't drawn enough to take action yet. So I started getting more curious, asking a lot more questions. Before service started, I kind of like took a moment to myself and kind of prayed and was like, God, if you're real, give me a sign, because I want to start a relationship with you, but I don't know if I was still kind of doubtful if he was real or not. So before then, I was just kind of like, okay, let's see how this goes. Walked in there, and like 5 or 10 minutes later, he started bringing up like our baggage. At that point in time, I was thinking I wanted to get saved, but I didn't know if I was ready to get saved. So I slept on it, and I prayed about it, and I thought about it. And then all of Thursday morning and afternoon, I thought about it. And after service, I talked to Kinsey, and I was like, I want to get saved. So Kinsey grabbed Seabeth, and right after service, she pulled us apart, and we went up to the cabin, and she took us out in the back of the kitchen, and there were no lights. It was pitch black, couldn't see anything. We literally had to use Seabeth's phone flashlight to see. And Kinsey led me to the Lord, and I got saved.